Hey guys, welcome to DevOps School. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about Kubernetes. Kubernetes is developed by Google and it is an open source platform that automates container operations. It eliminates many of the manual processes involved in deploying and scaling containerized applications. After going through this tutorial, I promise you that the concept and understanding of the Kubernetes will be absolutely clear to you. But before that, let me ask you a few things. Are you dreaming of a career with higher pay and more responsibilities? Or are you ready to take your skills to the next level this year? Then start investing in DevOps School certification level courses, which will help you to emerge skills for a wide range of entry-level roles and as well as higher potential future positions. But with thousands of courses online and in classroom worldwide, finding the right one for your career goals can be difficult. You can consider our courses like Agile Developer, Agile QA, DevOps Certified Professionals, Site Reliability Engineering, DevSecOps, and Masters in DevOps Engineering, where you will have access to well-structured, easy-to-follow course content that has been developed and will be delivered by industry professionals. You can join on our training programs globally through online platforms, and if you are looking for classroom workshops, then we have regular sessions available in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Delhi NCR, Mumbai, and in Pune. Simply compare our many courses, find the one that suits your style and schedule best, and start today.
Okay, so I'm talking about the replication controller. It has a two features. One is replication and another one is controller. The replications will make sure that it will replicate one pod to as many you want it, replicas, and controller will make sure that whatever the desired number of pods which you wanted, it will be in act. So let me show you the demo. So here I am going to create a replication controller. So here kubectl create hyphen h. So can I create a replication controller? You see that here? Do we have options to create a replication controller?
No.
No. That means I need to use the YAML file. Yes. So let's use the YAML file. So here GitHub. Okay, let's use that one of the YAML file to create a replication controller. Notes. I just need one sample code, though you can copy from the Google also, hardly matters because you have to change this image name. Okay, so see here, this is the code of the replication controller. Understand this here. API version v1, kind is equal to replication controller, name of the replication controller is hello RC. How many replicas you want? Two. Okay, and what is the replication controller spec? So if you see the replicas of spec, here you have containers name. This is the name, this is the image name, and then this is the port number. By the way, this image name is mine only, and it's the same image. What is the difference is just only difference. I've changed the index.html. So that's all. I did not do anything over there. So it's a replication controller. Again, if you want to know what are the other fields are available, so I told you, use the explain command to know about it. But whatever I have written so far, it's a required field. Okay. So I am going to copy this. Where I am, I go inside this cd kubernetes cd rajesh, and here virc.yaml. okay, now same thing I'm going to do. So CRUD operation, remember always. So from now onwards I'm not going to explain it, so you have to understand this. So here kubectl get rc, but where? Not in default. Let me check that how many of you have used the default by default. So here I can see Nagesh has created by default in the default. Anyways, so here get RC. If you want to get RC in Rajesh, do we have RC? No RC. No RC is there. So can I create it? So kubectl create hyphen F and name of the RC and hyphen N is equal to Rajesh. Now you see here get RC. See, two got created. Can I see the pods also? So two pods I got it. So here, see here, I got the two pods which is creating. You can describe all this thing I have taught you already. You can describe, you can attach, you can eject, you can log, you can CP, do whatever you want, access from the outside through IP address, all this thing you know that. it is a pod, right? You see here, there's some unique got added to the each pod, unique number got added. So that is how it is. So now this is got created. Now this got created. The two pod you got it. Now I'll show you the power of multiple. So now let me do that CRUD edit operations. Remember edit where it is here. So can I do that? So now edit name of the RC. I think it is hello RC, which is here. Okay, and hyphen name. I'm going to edit this one. Look at my screen, guys, please. I'm modifying the replicas. Look at this replicas. Where is the replicas? Replicas. It should be down, I guess. Huh, see here, it's a 2. I'll make it 2 to 20. Just see, you should not make it 20. I'm making 20 just to help you to visualize it, because there are 16 GB RAM. So I will delete also during the after the demo. So here, done. And you see here, 16 immediately got created. So how many? 2 you had it, and remaining, I think 18. Okay, so this each call, this feature, what we call it? This feature, what we call it? We call it
control
application. So I'll show you the control a little later. Just give me a second. So here you see. So within a second, you could upgrade your infrastructure to 1 to 1,000. If you have a nodes, within a seconds, you can upgrade your infrastructure to 10 to 10,000. Just imagine the power of containers and Kubernetes. Okay, so this is the thing. Now, what do you want? I will show you another way. vi rc.yaml, this also. Now, I don't want 20, I want only 5. So I'll set here and kubectl apply hyphen f rc.yaml hyphen n is equal to Rajesh and done. And can I show you this? Suddenly you see that. See, everything got terminated except 2. Okay, so this is how many it was there? I forgot.
Five,
like 2 or 4?
5.
Yeah, so here look at this 5. Okay, leave this first one. This why I created separately through pod.yaml. So guys, this is the power of replications. You can do that. And finally, you should delete it. But before delete, I will show you the power of a controller. What is a controller? I told you controller manager. Remember the controller manager, which manage the which has a multiple controller. So one of the controller what we have is this one. Okay, so now let me show you the controller, power of controller. I am accidentally deleting those pod. If you want to see that, how, which node it got created, look at this. So here, this one is creating 137, 137, 11, 137, 11. So you got 137 node, you got a 3 pod, and 11, you got a 2 pod. See, it's distributed equally. Okay, 2, 3, something like that. Okay, so now can we do one thing? Can we delete one of the pod? So I'll just delete this guy. Okay, clear the screen one more time. And here, so can I delete accidentally this pod? It may happen, right? One node get offline, few pod get corrupted. It may happen, and you see what happens. So kubectl delete pod and this pod and hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. And I deleted. Remember that deletion was made, and then replacement has to happen. So you are not doing anything. You are not being called out saying that production is down. See that? 12 seconds. So did you see the power of Kubernetes replication controller, controller manager? So controller manager will make sure that whatever the actual and desire, it should be in a sync. Did you understand that, guys?
Yes.
Yeah, so now what I'm going to do, if you want to delete the replication controller, really, you have to do this one. So this will delete everything because you are not deleting one of the pod. So kubectl delete hyphen f and rc.yaml hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. And I deleted and all this pod has gone. See? So RC is very powerful. RC is very powerful. It has a two feature, replication feature, controller feature, and these are the commands I run in order to show you the RC feature. Okay. Now, for this, I will give you 15 minutes. Okay. Try RC, and then I'll teach you one more objects. Next one, which is most important, deployment. So now what is the deployment I'll talk about after this lab? So let me update this notes. And here it is. Date to edit. Done. Okay, guys, go ahead. You have 15 minutes only for this.
This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, so the question was, can I make the pods which is not controlled by replication controller? Can it be controlled by the replication controller after that creation? So yes, the answer is yes. How it is, let me show you. So here apply hyphen f rc and hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. Okay, so now I created rc. Okay, so here this is the rc. Now if I describe this rc, all this command is already, you have shared, we have shared already, so you have to start keep using it and understand each and every fields, so that way it will help you to get comfortable with this platform. If you see that very carefully, go here and look at this here. This is the RC, name of the RC, replicas, and yeah, look at this here. Now this is from the replication controller. Now you see here, this is from who's controlling this? Replication controller. Now if you go to that pod, get pod, and you see one field. Okay, there's a pod. I'm going to one of the pod. You see that? What is the difference? Kubectl describe pod and hyphen n is equal to Rajesh, and then pod name is this one. And look at this very carefully, and you have volumes, you have to read it at least once, become comfortable. But I'm not looking for something but controller. So we'll go up, see here, look at this line, controlled by hello hyphen rc. So who's controlling this pod? Hello hyphen rc. Whereas if you look at this other pod, which is this one, which is not controlled by right now rc, look at this, controlled by none. You'll be having nothing controlled by. Look at this, there's no control. So if you edit that, add that field and say controlled by that the replication controller, it will start controlling actually. So that way, understood this?
Yeah,
understood this? Yeah. Okay, so guys, let's move on to the next feature, which is called deployment. Now what is the deployment?
Rajesh, one doubt on that. So we can add that existing nodes to this duplication controller, right? So will the state automatically change? Let's say we have declared with 4. Okay, now so that 4 parts are the one which will be it will take care. Now you are adding.
The moment, see here, what happens? The moment you have a number of replicas 4. And you added one more controlled by this, so they will immediately terminate one.
That's the job of the controller manager. So what you have to do, you have to modify in a certain ways, like you have to modify the replicas also. But one more thing here, typically you won't do this actually. It's possible, but you won't do that. Why? Because you don't control, don't modify this this way. You are in a production server. You don't, it's like, remember the games between the pet business versus cattle business? You won't do that because you are not in a pets business. You are in a cattle business. You modify, if you want to add one more, why can't you add one more replicas? Getting your points?
Okay.
In terms of understanding a field, what are the modifications it had, it happened? I'll just show. Let's move on. So here next topic is deployment. So guys, deployment has, it has a one of the feature which is called replication. Yes, it has the same feature, replication. It has a one more feature which is called controller. Yes, we have a controller feature. That means whatever the RC feature we had, we have in the deployment also. So you must be wondering and you must be thinking, why the hell we have a RC then? We have a deployment which has a similar feature, then why we have RC? So actually RC got deprecated. Deployment deployment is a replacement of RC with some additional feature. What are the feature? Let me tell you. Here, some of the bugs of RC got fixed here. Bugs got fixed here. Okay, that's the one thing. But we got additional feature also. Here, versioning is also there. Versioning. Okay, versioning is also there. Rollout is also there. You roll out the new version, right? 1.1 to 1.1, 1.2 to 1.2, like this. And rollback feature is also there. And this is in production right now. So these are the feature which we have in deployment. Okay, did you understand this?
Yeah.
So now I am going to show you the demo of this. So guys, I don't feel copying the YAML file now because I'm feeling lazy. So do we have any commands for it? So let's try to find out, do we have any commands for it or not? So kubectl and create hyphen h and then go up. And can I create a deployment through the command? Can I?
Yes.
Deployment. Yes. So yes, you can create. So RC was not there because it got deprecated. So of course it will not be there. So now I'm going to create deployment. But after that, I don't know. So again, I will ask a Kubernetes only. And here I got to know. Suddenly I got to know that this is a command which will create a one deployment from that with a deployment name with this one and from the image this one, BGBox. But guys, I'm not using this image. And there is a reason for it. Please use this image only because that way it will be easy for us to visualize the changes. This is the version one. Okay. So right now I am using my image and create deployment. Oh, sorry, my mistake. I did by wrong in the default namespace. I should have not done it. So let me do one thing. Let me delete also. Kubectl. Delete what deploy my dev. I deleted this one. Same CRUD operation, guys. I'm doing nothing great. You know that by now everything. So it's a repetitive work. Okay. So now deployment. So can I create deployment now? Here. Now can I see this kubectl get a deploy and hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. You have. So by default, I created a deployment, right? We have a deployment. One container is one pod is there. Let me show you. And there's RC also. So let me delete this, otherwise you'll get confused. So delete RC, hello RC. And this I deleted, hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. And clear the screen. And after that, I delete the pod also. Pod, which is hello pod hyphen n is equal to, it's a clean environment. Hello pod Rajesh. See here. So I deleted, I cleaned the environment. Now let's talk about the deployment. So I have only one get pod. You see here, get pod. I have only one, and deployment, if you see, deploy. And you see here, only one deployment. So now let's understand how can we do the replication. But you know one thing, the old method, we all used it. You know that edit you can do and modify the deployment replicas. For example, let me show you kubectl edit deploy shortcut. Okay, deploy shortcut, and what deploy my dep and which namespace Rajesh, and here go and it and change the replicas from 1 to 2. That we know, that you did it with the RC also. Okay, so but this time I will try something better option. See, this required interaction with the command line. I'm saving WQ, but this will not work with automation like a CI/CD. If you want to replicate to 1 to 2000 suddenly, so this will not work with the CI/CD because they cannot open up your VI editor and save or modify whatever it is. So is there any commands which will do that? Actually, I don't know, but we will find it out together. Okay, so can we see that any commands which will help me to do that stuff? Any idea?
Scale.
Yeah, scale. Auto scale means automatically it will do. It will not ask me. But here I am asking something. So here scale, not auto scale. Okay, a scale. Auto scale is automatically it will do. It will check the CPU, RAM, dip, this, dap, and all, and automatically it will do that. This is not how I want it. I want to do something through the command line. So here what I am going to do, kubectl scale. So you learned that, okay, there is a command to scale, but what? But if I don't know, hyphen H, what you can scale? You can scale replica set, RS. Replica set, replicate deployment, you can replicate replication controller, RC also. All these things you have. You can replicate stateful set also. What is stateful set? I'll teach you tomorrow after the volume, post lunch. Okay. So here, this is the deployment. My goal is deployment. So can we call this now? Copy paste, and here, current deployments, I don't need it. That's, I don't remember also, by the way. So I just need a replicas. How many replicas you want? Let's say I need 10 replicas. But which replicas? I forgot the name also. What was the name? My dep. Yeah. So my dep. So deployment, my dep. How many replicas you want? 10. Auto scale. This will work with the CI, right? This will work with the CI. Hyphen N is equal to Rajesh. And you see here, I got this scaled automatically. Get pod. See, and all the remaining command, you know that, like working with a pod, describe this, that. So please understand that for those commands, you can use with every API resources. You have to hard code the stuff. So not repeating the same thing again and again. But at least we did this, right? We did it. Now again, I'm going to make it only one or two. Let's make it.
You did edit, right? I mean, you didn't apply. Still, it took another spinning, another pod created.
Sorry, I didn't understand.
I mean, you made a edit command, right? It didn't. You're not that applied.
No. Edit is directly on the etcd. No, apply. Oh, okay. Will remember here. Go back to this. See here. Edit. I directly do the etcd. Here apply YAML. See here, YAML edit command line. See?
Got it. Yeah.
Thank so I was doing something. Yeah. So replicas we have 10. Okay. So now I'll downscale actually. So make it two. This CI because track is correct. This is a no intent there. So you see here, actually it's not responding. So here you press X. See, it's got to. You can see that this time I did some the power of replication, but different ways using the scale, because I wanted to teach. So did you understand that? What is your application, guys? Do you understand this? Guys, hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Your voice was breaking a lot, actually.
Your voice is breaking, actually. For me as well.
Oh, is that?
Yeah.
That is my network problem, too. Now it's better, Rajesh. You can
maybe problem from my side, I guess. Okay. So, yeah. So, guys, did you understand this replication feature? How can I use the scale command to do the replications? Everyone?
Yes, Rajesh.
Okay. I'll keep saving the commands, otherwise I'll lose this. Okay. So now I'll show you the controller. Controller is damn simple. But you know, here there is a different controller. It's not a replication controller. It's a different controller. How can I see that? So look at this here. Get pod. See here. There's one pod, right? Go here and kubectl describe and pod name. Okay. Hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. And here if I see which is controlled by. So look at this here. Who's controlled by? See here. Replica set. So you just look at this here. Look at this here. What has happened? Replication controller RC was initially developed. Okay. Initially it was developed RC. Now what has happened? Bug were fixed. And make it RS, replica set. Some bugs were fixed. So RC is as it is. But they released the new API, the new API object, replica set. So using replication controller, whatever you can do with the replication replica set also. But, replica set, they attach to the deployment. And deployment got additional feature, versioning, rollout, rollback. So now you got all these features in the deployment. This is how the development has taken place over the period of last, I think, two and a half years. Make sense? Now, see here. This is controlled by replica set. I'm losing my... So here, kubectl get RS. See. And see replica set, name of the replica set 2. Now replica set is controlled by, if you see that, describe this, you know all this command, you know that. So describe RS, what is the name of RS, this RS, and describe, sorry, hyphen n is equal to Rajesh, and describe who's controlling this replica set, deployment. Did you understand this? What is the relationship?
Yes.
Yeah. So now someone has asked me in the morning, replica set. Someone has. So this is a replica set. Replica set is inbuilt with the deploy. Is inbuilt with the deployment, and which will do that RC plus work. That means all the bugs which we had in the replication controller, which got fixed in the replica set. And then got controlled by deployment. So now you can individually also you can use it, but people don't use it. Okay, they use it with a deployment always, because this is the one which we use everywhere in the production. Okay, so now this is the controlled. So this is the controller. So now I'll teach you how can it be doing the same functionality. So let's do that. So here kubectl get pods hyphen n is equal to Rajesh, and you see here there's a two pod. I will delete one pod. So delete pod. By intentionally I'm deleting hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. Okay, and here you can see that it got deleted, and it has been replaced already, but because of the output is little bit refreshing, and then you get to see little later. See here, look at the age, 15 seconds replaced. So that means deployment also has a replication controller, replica set, which is control the design. So this is replica set. replicas set. Guys, is that okay? Did you understand this?
Yes.
Guys, okay. Now I will teach you versioning. What is a versioning? So guys, what happens when you change the image? Okay, understand that. When you change the image from 1 to 1.2, automatically versioning is inbuilt feature. You don't have to do that. Okay, versioning is inbuilt feature. For example, workflow, total workflow. This is your standards. Total workflow. This is your cluster, and this is your gate, and this is you. This is your workstation. So what you will do? Let's say there is a box. Understand that there is a box in the new deployment. Deployment number 1.2 box has found. It's a new deployment. Suddenly you need to roll back to 1.1, which was not having any problem, but just deploy 1.2. So suddenly you have a 1.1. Now what you will do? The moment you find out the box in 1.2, you have to roll back 1.1. Correct. Now the question is, what you will do? You will of 1.2 in your workstation from Git, check out and then apply, and then those rollback will happen. But this will consume, let's say, 2 to 3 minutes. Yes, this will take 2 to 3 minutes, this flow. But it's also manual. So can we, if some bugs is found?
Rajesh, your voice is breaking. So just me or for everyone?
No, even
not back, or maybe this time you can reduce to 5 seconds.
Rajesh?
What
Rajesh as part of the question is, how do we last couple of minutes talk?
Yes.
You may need to repeat last 2 minutes of discussion. We are not able to hear it clearly. Was it?
So I was talking about the versioning. Okay, versioning. Okay,
yeah, you can proceed from where the paint, from there it started actually.
Yeah, okay, so this is the production server and we deployed version 1.2. okay, and with a new feature. Version 1.2 was 1.1 is a older feature. So what has happened? Suddenly in the new deployment you found out the bugs. Okay, so now what we have to do, we need to roll back 1.1, because it's a problem in the 1.2. so now roll back, either you do through apply again, this is your workstation, and you will do the rollback through this one. It will take 2 to 3 minutes at least. Okay, but what you can do, if you sure about, okay, this is having some issues, you want to roll back, and for that only the deployment is giving the versioning. You can roll back any point of the time. This versioning get enabled when you change the image minimum. Okay, so the question is, how can I see the versioning? Guys, are you able to listen to me? Because I don't know whether the network is
clear. Go ahead.
Yeah. So here, versioning. So for that, what I'm doing, kubectl, I don't know the command for, again, timeout has happened. Lots of timeout is happening today actually. Okay, so here I will go and check this kubectl. I don't know how to check out the versioning. So can you help me out?
Kubectl version-h. Okay, here.
You can use rollout.
Yeah, rollout. Yes. So guys, rollout has that command. So let me check. I don't know after the rollout also. So can we check? Now you see available commands. How many commands you have? See here, history commands. You can check the versioning. Watch. You can undo the things. You can roll back. This is a roll back. You can roll out also, and you can see the status also. You can pause the rollout. You can restart the rollout and resume the paused resources. So many things you can do that. But right now I'm talking only about the versioning, not rollout, not rollback. I'll talk about one by one. So this is the history command. So here what we have, history. So can I check this history? After that, I also don't know. So here what you have to give, you have to give the deployment name or daemon set name. What is a daemon set? I'll teach you. But what is a deployment? What is the deployments? My depth. So let's apply history my depth, and the name of the my depth, I think I noted down in my notes, and my depth. So here, enter. Oh, sorry, my mistake. I should not be hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. See that. How many versions we have?
None.
One version, no? Revision number one. Right? So I deploy only one image. Can I change the image now? Yes, I can change that image. Let me change the image. So before that, guys, before changing, let me tell you one thing. Get pod. Okay. So kubectl get pod -n is equal to Rajesh. And here, okay. kubectl Rajesh. This is the pod. Can I get the IP address? White. Look at this, guys. This is the IP address. I do the curl, okay? So curl http --. See that here. What is printed? Can you please read it to my confirmation?
Welcome to Dev School.
And version one. So this is the version one. Now I'll do that version two. How can you roll out the version two? Look at this. Look at me. So here I am going to list out my deployment. I'm very lazy actually. So I don't want to write, but forcefully they are asking me to write. So get deploy, and here edit deploy and my depth and -n is equal to Rajesh, and I will change the image. Yes, you can change the image. So it'll become a new deployment altogether. How can you change the image? Look at this, some places. This is the container. Look at this. I have to read it very carefully. Lots of fields, runtime create lots of field. Where is that? Here it is. See here. What is the image? Last keyword, please read it. V1, right? I will make it V2. Okay. Nothing I did, just change the image. And done. Can I see the pod? See here, guys. You got this pod 0x1. See, it's not ready right now. Okay. See here. Container is getting created. And now we changed it. See here. And I will remove that white because I don't need right now. And see here. Okay. So still that terminating the older one and creating a new one. Wait for it. See, now you got it. So deployment has happened, but how it has happened, I did not teach you, but I will teach you little bit later. First, let me talk about the complete the history. So history, see, it's done. So now can I check this O white? And IP address curl http --. See, can you please read the last one?
Version two.
I roll out basically without explaining, but I want to go and check the version two. Do we have the revision stored by the deployment or not? So for that rollout history, here it is. And look at this. So this is the way versioning. This is what I was talking about. Any deployments you change, this versioning automatically happen. Do you understand this versioning, guys?
Yeah, yes. I have one question. That image that you change to version one to version two, right?
Right.
So do we have version two also? There's an image.
Just a second, sir. I'll copy else I'll time out. No, we'll lose sure, that sure. All the command. Yeah, okay. So, of course, I was having that's the reason I used it, you know, otherwise it will give you that crashing error and all.
Oh, that's right. No, just talking about in case just changing the name here. It's deployment is replicating the name over there.
No, that image has to be there. No, without that, how can you create a container? Okay. Remember the rule: container is running, yes, then only pod is running. Remember?
Sure. Yep.
Yeah. So guys, here I did discussed about deployment has a multiple feature. I discussed about how to create a deployment through the command line. I also discussed about how to replicate through scale that other one which you know already. Okay, all this thing. And then also I discussed how the controller works. This time the controller is replica set. Please work with it. Commands, you have it here. Not here. Okay, by the way, commands got missed out for replica set. I'm RS. I will ask you the special instruction. Work with RS. When I say work with RS, that means CRUD operation. That's all. Okay, please understand this. Okay, and I showed you the versioning also. Okay, any questions so far? Before I'll talk about this rollout and rollback a little bit later. Any questions so far? Okay, so now I'll give you for this 15.
If you liked our Kubernetes session so far, please enroll for our channel membership 399 plan to get access of all the parts. Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the 399 plan and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.